I can take it, I can make it.
The most powerful tool that you have right now in your life, in your body, is your mind. That's why the enemy fights you in your mind. The devil doesn't have to tie you up for you to be bound. He just has to tie up your head with stress, with worry, with aggravation, with low self-esteem, with pettiness, with anger, with hostility, with rebellion. And he can make you physically sick because your mind is sick. Lay your hands on your head and say, give me a new mind. Give me a new mind means give me a new perspective. Give me a new perspective. Give me a new way of looking at my situation. Give me a new way of looking at my circumstances. Get my mind ready for this year, because when I get this year, there's going to be blessings. There's going to be miracles. There's going to be opportunities. Oh, yes, it's going to be some struggles. It's going to be some challenges. It's going to be some tests. But even the struggles are an opportunity for me to show off the victory if my mind can handle the change.
If you can take it, you can make it. If you can take it, you can make it. All right, you train, you fight way harder than those other guys, and you win. You get out from under. If you can take it, you can make it. You can do this. Just gotta believe you can.
There's some things I'm not taking with me in the new year. Everything that's inflexible and everything that's not ready and everything that's backwards and everything that's negative and everything that's condescending and everything that's carnal and everything that's holding me back, I refuse to take it over into another year and waste another new year with an old mind. Shape yourself around the comings and goings of this world. Don't shape your opinions and your attitudes around circumstances that you cannot change. If you go into another year and waste another year with the old mentality while somebody's in the hospital begging God for the opportunity that you have right now, you better step into this moment. As soon as you decide to stop looking for answers in other people and miracles somewhere down the yellow brick road and click the heel to your mind, you could have been free years ago. You can get your mind out, you can get your money out, you can get your family out, you can get your job out, you can get your career out, you can get your health out. You can get your prosperity out. If you can get your mind out, no devil in hell, no weapon formed against you, no enemy that hates you, no witch that hexes you can stop you from being free. If you can get your mind out, grab yourself by the hand and say, we're coming out of there. Tell them I'm coming out head first.
I think that among the things that prevent us from acting is the fear of failure. And if you've already failed, you don't want to fail again. The pain of that, the disappointment. Many of us don't act because we want other people's approval. We want everybody to like us and to accept us. We're settling for less than what we actually deserve. We don't feel good about it, but we make it work in our minds. We'll come up with some kind of excuse to make it all right.
Most people like to feel like they're a king in the area of their comfort zone. They only want to do those things that they know how to do well.
So there are many reasons why we don't act. There are other things, though, that affect us. Is that not wanting to take personal responsibility. We want somebody else to do it, and that's not possible.
And when you go through life like that, something in you dies.
You need to start asking yourself some questions. What do I really, really, truly want? Don't wait around for things to be just right. Don't wait for things to be perfect. Don't wait for the ideal situation. It will never be ideal.
Today, this opportunity you have, it might not be here next year. It might not be here the year after next. It might not be here the year after that. This is the only moment you got.
And what you will find, that when you decide to act, when you decide to take life on, and let me warn you, it can be painful, it will be uncomfortable, and that's where the growth is. Never be satisfied with yourself. Always know that as you invest the effort and time on you, that's the greatest ability that human beings have above animals. See, a dog can't be anything but a dog. Tree can't be anything but a tree. Human being, you've got unlimited potential. You can put effort on you, and by concentrating on you and developing you, you can transform your life wherever you are right now. Many people will leave the universe without a trace. No one will know they were here. What will you leave? What will be different because you came this way?
Listen to that still small voice within you. Don't try and make everything logical. There's some things about life that defies logic. See, there's some good out there for you in the universe that has your name on it, and nobody can get your good. It has your name on it. They can't take your stuff. It's your stuff. So when you know that, when you know that whatever you're seeking, it's also seeking you, you don't worry. You don't run scared. You don't think somebody's going to take it from you.
You've got to say yes. Yes to my dreams. Yes to me. Yes. I can make it. Yes, I can.
You don't need anybody to approve your dream. It was given to you. If they can't see it, it's because it wasn't given to them. It was given to you.
You're gonna get thrown to the ground again and again and again. But when you have determination and you know that what you're doing is right, it gives you your life, it gives a special meaning and power to you. I refuse to be denied. And I'm going to go all out. I'm going to be relentless. I don't care how many no's I encounter. Doesn't matter how many failures I've made. Doesn't matter how many mistakes I've endured. Doesn't matter about my defeats. Doesn't matter about what I've done. Yes. Yes! Yes, I can!
I understand now you are attracted to greatness because greatness is all in you. But it's easier to watch greatness. It's easier to go see greatness than it is to put in the time, to put in the energy, to discipline yourself, to sacrifice. It's easier. And so that's why you average.
You've been doing the same thing. You at the same job. You're experiencing the same things in your life. Nothing has changed.
Everything about you is phenomenal, but you've consciously made a decision to be average. You are average in school. You're average at your workplace. Like, everything you do is average, and not because it's average, but because you made a decision. You made a choice to be average. Why? Because the people around you are average. Or maybe you grew up in an average environment, or went to an average school, or you worked for an average company, and so you've decided to go against who you are.
No one else feels sorry for you. Only you do. That's the type of mindset why people aren't successful at life. They sit there and they feel sorry for themselves, and they want all this fucking sympathy from everybody else. Yet they're not willing to go out there and make shit happen for themselves.
Because this is not for everyone. This is not for the faint at heart. This is for people who have goals and dreams that they want to achieve.
Everyone seems to think that this world, this government, somebody owes them something. Nobody owes you shit. If you want something, go out there and get it. Go out there and fucking take it. That's all there is to it.
You could be great if you just showed up. Get in the game. Quit. Stop playing. You deserve to see what your life would look like if you gave 120%.
You gotta run after your destiny. You gotta run after your destiny. Because success is never an accident. And if you don't want it, get out of my way. Because there are some people who want to do something with their life who will run.
The choice that we have, though, is either to give up or keep on going. I want to ask you, what are you going to believe? Are you going to believe in yourself? Are you going to believe everybody else's judgment on you?
Like, I want your dream to be so clear, so vivid, right? That when you wake up in the morning, all you got to do is step in your dream.
I didn't get it until I got to this age, but I'm gonna start running. I messed up junior high, but now I'm gonna start running. I messed up high school, but now I'm gonna start running. The moment you get the word, you ought to run. The Bible said, the day you hear my voice, harden not your heart. When God gives you a chance at an escape, don't be cute, run after your destiny. My God, run! Run, do y'all hear me? Run after it! Don't be ashamed! Run!
You might be taller than me, you might be bigger than me, you might be stronger than me, but I'm coming, and I'd rather die trying. I'd rather give a year. I'd rather put in work and fail.
The harder you work, the harder it is to surrender. And that's in every aspect of life.
Like this is your last day on the planet.
I deserve to see what my life would look like if I gave 120%.
I would rather aim for the stars and not hit them than to not aim at all. I would rather go after it and not get it than not go after it at all. I'd rather try and fail than not try at all. I don't want to live with the idea, wonder what would have happened had I done more with my life. I'm gonna go for it, come hell or high water. I'm going after my destiny. You gotta run after your destiny. You can't stroll after your destiny. You can't walk after your destiny. You gotta run after your destiny. Run after it, run after it, run! If you just run after what's in front of you, you will escape what's behind you. Don't spend all your time trying to fix what's behind you, because you'll never be able to fix what's behind you. You have to run after what's in front of you.
I don't believe in the word procrastination. Like, I don't really believe in that word. I told a young lady in Australia who told me she was a procrastinator. I said, look, if I told you to meet me here tomorrow at 5 a.m., and I'm gonna give you $3 million, where would you be? She said, I'll be right there at 4:59, ready to get that $3 million. And I said, so then there's no such thing as procrastination. What it is it's not important to you. Right? It's not meaning for you, to you. It's not something that's urgent to you. And when something is not urgent, you put it off. So, yep, you're in school, yes. You probably are getting grades, etc. But if it's not meaningful to you, if it's not important to you, then you're not gonna make it a priority. So what you have to do is find out, how can you make it meaningful? How can you make it purposeful? How can you make it stick? And when you can find that out, I promise you, you'll get up early, you'll get there first, and you'll do whatever it takes to make that goal a reality. So for me, no such thing as procrastination. It's a such thing as it's not a priority to you.
You said that you were going to graduate this year. You were going to finish college this year. You said you were going to run a marathon, right? This is what you said out of your mouth. All I'm doing is I'm saying, listen to me, I'm not telling you what to do. I'm not telling you should do this. You should do that, you should do this. I didn't tell you all year what you should do, but what I did tell you is don't talk about it, be about it. You should be tired, all right? You should be tired of talking about it, and you should be at a place where you're doing something about it, all right? The reason why you have not become successful, the reason why you are not like a locomotive, the reason why you are not having success in your life is because every single day you got an excuse. And I need you to do me a favor. I made my last excuse yesterday, my last reason. I came up with my last reason yesterday of why I can't do what I'm supposed to do. And so I need you to do me a huge favor. All your excuses, all your good reasons, everything that's keeping you from doing what you're supposed to do, I need you to put it behind you and say, yesterday was the last day for that foolishness. Yesterday was the last day to say, I don't have enough money to do this. I don't have enough money to go to school. I don't have enough money to get a computer. I don't have what it takes. I'm not smart enough, right? I don't write well enough. I don't sing well enough. That's why I didn't do my CD. I didn't write my book because I'm not on that level. Listen to me. You better hear what I'm saying. Yesterday was the last day that I want to hear an excuse. It's over with. I was embarrassed. I said, listen to me, no more defeats. No more defeats, man. No more. I was tired of feeling defeated. I was tired of talking about I was gonna do it and didn't do it. And I hated the feeling of when somebody asked me, yo, E, where the book? I ain't got it. I was tired of getting beat. I was tired of defeat. I said, I'm gonna get it done. Every time you set this big goal, you never get it accomplished because you never break it up in manageable pieces. This is it. I'm talking about procrastinators. You still have time. Don't quit. Don't give up. You still have time. You can do it. You can make it happen, but you can't do it procrastinate. You can't do it talking about it, all right? So I just want to go back and recap because I want to make sure you hear what I'm saying. But I dare you, I double dare you to do exactly what you said you were going to do when the year started, because it's not too late.
Your life is your life. Don't let it be clubbed into dank submission. There are ways out. There is a light somewhere. It may not be much light, but it beats the darkness. Beyond the watch, the gods will offer you chances. Know them. Take them. You can't beat death, but he can beat death in life, sometimes. And the more often you learn to do it, the more light there will be. You are marvelous. The gods wait to delight. Beware those who seek constant crowds, for they are nothing alone. Beware the average man, the average woman. Beware their love. Their love is average, seeks average. They will attempt to destroy anything that differs from their own. Not being able to create art, they will not understand art. Stay out of the clutches of mediocrity. Invent yourself, and then reinvent yourself. Change your tone and shape so often that they can never categorize you. Reinvigorate yourself and accept what is, but only on the terms that you have invented and reinvented. Be self-taught and reinvent your life because you must. It is your life, and its history and the present belong only to you. If neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you, but none too much, if you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours is the earth and everything that's in it. All the others are a test of your endurance, of how much you really want to do it. And you'll do it, despite rejection and the worst odds. And it will be better than anything else you can imagine. If you're going to try, go all the way. This could mean losing girlfriends, wives, relatives, jobs, and maybe your mind. Go all the way. It could mean not eating for 3 or 4 days. It could mean freezing on a park bench. It could mean jail. It could mean derision. Mockery, isolation. Isolation is the gift. If you're going to try, go all the way. Otherwise, don't even start. You will be alone with the gods, and the nights will flame with fire. Do it. Do it. If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you, if you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, if you can wait and not be tired by waiting, if you can force your heart and nerve and sinew to serve your turn long after they are gone, and so hold on when there is nothing in you except the will that says to them, do it. Rage, rage, rage against the dying of the light. Do not go gentle into that good night.
This is how I end.
During those down moments,
That's where the growth takes place.
Are you hearing me? Some of you have been knocked out by life.
The real challenge of growth, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually, comes when you get knocked down.
I want my daughter back. I'm her father.
Unfortunately, that's not enough.
May I remind you? But you were born in the dark, shaped by the dark, molded by the dark.
So what do you do when you fall down?
We can fight our way back into the light.
You can recycle your pain. Get something from it. You're already in pain. Use it. Do something with it. Allow it to take you to the next level. Allow your pain to push you to greatness.
Get up! Get up!
Sometimes in life, you have to hit back.
Everybody's trying to stop you. Everybody's trying to kill your dream. You're going to prove all of them wrong.
I don't care what the scoreboard says. We're going to be winners.
So now you got to go out and show them that I'm a different creature. Now! Than I was 5 minutes ago.
This is your time. Now go out there and take it.
You know what you're worth? Now go out and get what you're worth.
Again and again and again, the lights are cut off, but you're still looking at your dream, reviewing it every day, and say to yourself, it's not over until I win.
Make a declaration to yourself. I'm unstoppable. This will not get me down.
Live your life now. Live your dreams now.
If you want to be successful, here's the thing you have to do. You have to jump. There is no way around. You have to jump. Every successful person has jumped. You got to jump. You got to take a leap of faith. You got to dash off that cliff and you got to jump out there as far as you can. Now, a lot of times you stand on the cliff of life and you see other people soaring by, gliding down like a bird flying through the air. You know, they going over to the south of France. You see them on a boat somewhere. You see their family vacationing here, their family vacationing there. You see them dressing like this. You see them in New York, then you see them in London. They flying by. You know why? It's because their parachute opened. But the only way to get your parachute to open so you can soar, you got to jump. Now here's the problem. Here's the problem, my friends. When you jump, I can assure you one thing. You listening? I promise you this. Your parachute will not open right away. No, that's the fear part. I promise you, your parachute will not open right away. You're gonna hit them sides and them rocks. You're gonna tear your back out on them cliff. You're gonna cut yourself. You're gonna get wounded. You're gonna get some tears and stuff like that. But eventually, your parachute will open and you'll be soaring. But here's the other caveat. Let me teach you this right here. If you do not jump, I promise you one thing. Your parachute will never open. So you're safe, but you'll never soar. You got to jump.
A lot of times people believe in certain things, but they keep to themselves. They don't put it out there. You truly believe in it. If you become vocal with it, you are creating that law of attraction and it will become reality.
I'm a professional MMA fighter with a record of 4-1. I'm an up-and-coming fighter, and without a doubt, you will see me on the UFC in the near future, without a doubt.
If you can see it here, and you have the courage enough to speak it, it will happen.
The number one thing is you have to have a very clear vision, a very clear goal of where you want to go, because only then you will get there. You can have the best airplane or the best ship in the world, but if the captain doesn't know where to go, he will just drift around. If the pilot does not know where to go, he will just drift around with his plane. So it's, I think the key thing is that we know where we are going and that you're very passionate about that. And you see it always in front of you, the goal.
Nobody knows what you can do but you. Nobody can tell you. If I tell you all the people who told me I wasn't going to act or sing or dance or I wasn't good at it or I should stop or I should quit or even after I became famous, you know, for doing these things, you know, I would be locked in a house somewhere doing nothing. The truth is nobody knows what's inside of you. Only you know what's inside of you. Only you know what you can accomplish.
If you're doing anything interesting in the world, you're gonna have critics. The only way, if you absolutely can't tolerate critics, then don't do anything new or interesting.
Don't listen to the naysayers, because there's always people out there that will tell you that you will not be able to do that, forget it, it's a stupid dream that you have, or a crazy vision of those. Don't listen to the naysayers.
And you're at home watching and you're being called weird, or you're being called different, or whatever the hell you're being called, I'm here tonight to tell you, your critics do not count. Their words will fade. You won't.
The other thing that's important is that you got to shoot for the top. You got to go and really have big goals and think big, because then you're going to get big. Then you're going to go and achieve big things. That is the most important thing. You know, we don't achieve big things by accident.
Every challenge I take, I have a big vision. I put a lot of effort, a lot of sacrifice in things I do. If I don't do it, it means I don't believe in it. In this, I believe very strong, and I will not give up until I'm top of the world. So that's the way it works. You aim for the top, you don't aim for the second. Second place is the first place among the last ones, and that's not my target.
If you feel you have something to give, if you feel that your particular talent is worth developing, is worth caring for, then there's nothing you can't achieve.
If they can do it, I can do it. And that's the mentality. If somebody else can do it, you can do it. And I said to myself, I will do it and I will do it better. That's the mentality. And I believe with the mentality is 50% of the success in what you're doing.
People say you have to have a lot of passion for what you're doing. And it's totally true. And the reason is because it's so hard that if you don't, any rational person would give up. It's really hard. And you have to do it over a sustained period of time. So if you don't love it, if you're not having fun doing it, you don't really love it, you're going to give up. And that's what happens to most people, actually. If you really look at the ones that ended up, you know, being successful, unquote, in the eyes of society and the ones that didn't, oftentimes it's the ones that are successful loved what they did so they could persevere when it got really tough. And the ones that didn't love it quit because they're sane, right? Who would want to put up with this stuff if you don't love it? So it's a lot of hard work and it's a lot of worrying constantly. And if you don't love it, you're going to fail.
And you got to push your body. You got to overcome. It's like you're moving past a barrier. Moving a step forward. A lot of people just want to stop because they're dead tired, but you gotta do that extra one. That's when you improve.
If you think that you're gonna go and accomplish something really special and be the best in anything in the world, and you think you can do it without working, you make a big mistake. Because no matter what I did, if it was in bodybuilding or in acting or if it was in the political arena, it always took a lot of work.
Work your butt off. You never want to fail because you didn't work hard enough. I never wanted to lose a competition or lose an election because I didn't work hard enough. I always believed leaving no stone unturned. Muhammad Ali, one of my great heroes, had a great line in the 70s when he was asked, "How many sit-ups do you do?" He said, "I don't count my sit-ups. I only start counting when it starts hurting, when I feel pain. That's when I start counting, because that's when it really counts. That's what makes you a champion." That's the way it is with everything. No pain, no gain.
Do you mean that the competition is not the reality?
Listen, the work is behind the scenes. Competition is the easy part. Behind the scenes is where the work is done. Everything is done to get to that one race that you need to run.
you gotta do. Do it.
Think of some major goal you want, or maybe it's one you're already working on and you have experienced a lot of setbacks, a lot of defeats. You've experienced a lot of disappointment. Maybe you've already given up. And maybe you just need a little fire, a little encouragement to get back in the game again. There are winners, there are losers, and there are people who have not discovered how to win.
Nothing is impossible. The only thing that's impossible is what you make impossible. So I need you to understand that it's not going to be an easy road. But I'm telling you, if you're willing to put in 120%, if you're willing to go all in, you can take that which was once impossible and make it possible.
Not only is it possible for you to have your dream, but it's necessary that you go for what is yours in the universe. You do what it is you're supposed to. You're supposed to build something. You're supposed to create something. I don't know how to do it. Learn. It's you. It's on you. You got to make that happen. Nobody's going to bring it to you on a silver platter and say, here's your dream manifested. No, it's hard. Yes, it's hard. It's difficult. Yes, right. And it's worth it.
I want you to hold on. It may not happen in the time that you think is going to happen, but I want you to know something. If you quit, it's never going to happen. If you quit, if you give up, if you stop, if you do not persevere, listen to me, you will never see it.
The major key to your reaching your dream, your living up to your greatness, your making your contribution is you.
What do you need to know to be, to do, to have what you want that you don't know right now? What do you need? And so I'm asking you this question. You got to get this one. What do you need to know that you don't know right now? What information, what books do you need to read? What mentors do you need? What circles do you need to hang around?
See, if you know what your life work is, I encourage you to start working on it. If you can't do it all at one time, do just a little bit of it.
And you've got to actually go in a room, close the door, and you've got to see yourself doing it. You've got to feel yourself doing it. You've got to actually walk in it. You've got to go in the future, live it out, come back in the present, and start working toward it. Promise me this. 5 to 10 minutes that you will devote to seeing yourself being successful. And so I need you to do this for me. Like, I don't care what happens in your life. I don't care what it looks like. I don't care where you are. Every single day you wake up, if you're gonna have energy, if you're gonna have passion, if you're gonna have drive, every day you wake up, you've gotta start with that vision. It may not happen in 6 months. It may not happen in a year. It may not happen in 2 years. But at some point, my dream is going to become a reality. Every single day, we're not waiting for it to happen. We just don't have sight. Sight is for people who live in the present. We have vision. We're going to make it happen before it happens.
You gotta write, even if no one published your book, write, because that was given to you to do. Everything in you is telling you to stop, to give up. Every muscle is aching, and you're saying to yourself,
you can do it. Where you are is temporary. You will not be there for the rest of your life.
All the people couldn't see it. A lot of people didn't believe it. You were attacked. You were criticized. People were opposing you, but you kept on doing it. It was hard. It was rough. It was difficult. But to you, it was worth it.
You have to know that this thing is going to work.
Say this to yourself every day. I can write my own book. I can have my own business. I can take the trip and travel around the world. It's possible. I can bounce back from adversity and reinvent my life. It's possible.
There's something about the way we perceive success that results in one of the greatest tragedies of our time. And that's the belief that successful people, the ones at the top of their game, that talent is what punched their ticket, that destiny is what brought them to the finish line, and that's wrong. It's wrong because it takes the journey, it takes the struggle, the scratching and clawing that it takes to get to the top of the mountain, and it throws it out the window. Right? It completely mitigates what's most important. In the real world, the one we are living in, it doesn't matter who you are never entitled to a result. Victory is a product of the fight. And the biggest favor you can ever do for yourself as you progress through life's ups and downs, through the good, the bad, through rough times, is know that you are going through what every successful person, every champion, every innovator in the history of mankind has gone through. Struggle is perfection in progress. It's a sign that you are in the midst of what separates the great from average. It's a necessary step, and it's the most important step you will ever take, because 99% of people cannot see past it. The world sees struggle, hardship, as a time to pack it up, to walk away, to be intimidated. But the best, I'm telling you, they look at struggle differently. Just like you can't get fit without the blood, the sweat, the tears at the gym, you can't make deals without the hustle, you can't make things happen if you don't move forward in the face of adversity. When the word no is staring you in the eyes, that's all part of the process. Winners walk on. From Lincoln to Jordan to Oprah, we've heard the stories. But so often we're hesitant to implement the work ethic, the winning formula. It doesn't change. And it never will. But part of that is not being afraid to fail, right? Not being scared of rejection. Welcome that. Allow each attempt, any small failure that comes your way, to stack up. So at the end of the day, you can stand on them and reach levels of success that simply were not there a year ago, 2 years ago. You know, we didn't decide to put a human on the moon and expect it to happen the following Tuesday. Excellence takes time. Achievements take patience. Learning, reassessing. It's a pursuit that must be tenacious. Right, where getting knocked down isn't a detriment, it's a blessing, because it's refining our approach. We want that, we need it. Overshooting your potential will never be a problem, because if you want it bad enough, you will stretch yourself. You will find a way. It's aiming low that kills us, that destroys greatness at its roots, because we kill it before we even give it a chance to grow. And the safe road, my friend, holds no victories, only regrets. You can ask me 100 times, and I will answer the same way every single time. I would always trade discomfort now for victory later. It may seem like a lot to ask, it may appear tough, but trust me, the price is much steeper later on to sit back, let life go by, and wish that we turned our opportunity into something real.
So your questions, your anxiety should never revolve around whether or not you're comfortable. Because if you want something bad enough, you know that being uncomfortable is an ingredient. Your question should be whether you are giving enough. Whether that person next to you, who wants the same thing you want, by the way, will be able to give the effort that you can. Will be able to man up and make the sacrifice that you have. If you want to be the best, your mindset needs to reflect the best. You need to think differently than ordinary people, right? Let others focus on the tip of the iceberg. You know that excellence lies in everything underneath the surface, in what cannot be seen. That's your gold mine. That's your ticket. So take mediocrity and make it excellence. Take what's yours and hold it up for the world to see, because what hurts now, in the present, is the very same thing that will transform your life down the road.
The number one thing that's going to change your life, the only thing that will change your life, change your business, change your money, change your relationship, is you must raise your standard.
Your life can be too big to allow yourself to play too small.
The only thing that changes our life long term is when we raise our standards. It means that all of us in life have things we want. We don't get what we want, we get what we have to have.
What you're looking for and what you're talking about and what you need is self-discipline. Now, self-discipline, as the very term implies, comes from the self. It comes from you. It comes from when you make a decision to be disciplined. When you make a decision to be better. When you make a decision to do more and to be more.
Well, I think the one thing that discipline definitely does help you with is it helps you get things done. And when you get things done, when you actually do things, you have more success.
Make some choices. With new choices, you're going to get new results. With new results, you're going to get transformation.
When you're no longer willing to tolerate something, that's when your life changes.
Develop the habits. You've got the brain power, you've got the energy, but develop the habits of success.
We know that one of the things about high achievers, they all have goals. So literally, without goals, you're directionless. You will be used. See, people without goals get used by other people who have them. People that don't have goals work for people who do.
But you know about Michael Phelps? What allowed him to be able to push beyond that moment is his rituals. Go study the guy. Most people who swim have these unbelievable workouts. He does 2 and 3 of those workout sessions a day. All the other swimmers in the beginning thought he was insane. You can overtrain, you can't do that, it's not physically possible. But he had a standard and the rituals to back it up.
If it was easy, everybody would be doing it. There are always gonna be ups and downs, but I think it's really how you really, you know, get back on your horse and keep going forward. And I think the biggest thing that I've always said is never give up. And I never have, and nobody ever should. If they want something bad enough, they'll get it. They have to work for it. Yeah, it's not going to be easy. But if you want it bad enough, they'll do whatever it takes to get there.
If you look at great athletes, for example, it's not that they were naturally talented, whether it's a Kobe or a Michael Jordan or a Federer. It was the quality of their rituals.
If you think you can make a difference, it requires commitment.
The pro goes to work, and it doesn't matter if you're sick, doesn't matter if you have kids, it doesn't matter what you're a pro, and you go to work, and that just, it puts it in your head that this is what I do.
If you don't do the work steadily every day, like an athlete going to the gym and practicing, If you don't do the work, if you don't act on the ideas, if you don't integrate them, if you don't show some self-discipline, no idea will work unless you do the work.
Everyone in the world has a list of things they think they should do. I should lose weight. I should work out. I should work harder. I should. And then you know what? What changes people is when your should becomes a must. When suddenly the thing you said should happen has to happen. That's when human beings change.
Unless you take some new action, unless you start thinking some new thoughts, unless you start having some new conversation, unless you have the guts to clean out some of the things that are not working and install some of the new rituals that will work, nothing will change.
The road to success is through commitment and through the strength to drive through that commitment when it gets hard. And it is going to get hard and you're going to want to quit sometimes, but it'll be colored by who you are and more who you want to be.
You have only one life, so don't waste it.
When I was 16, I quit school.
I saved just enough for a one-way ticket to Paris. Maybe I just wanted it really bad, and then when I got it too early, I didn't know how to hold on to it.
If you do what is easy, complain about your situation, your circumstances. If you do what is easy, stand around and be a volunteer victim like everybody else. If you do what is easy, surrender and give up on your dreams, become depressed and bitter and angry. Anybody can do that. If you do what is easy, your life will be hard. But if you do what is hard, keep coming back again and again and again. If you do what is hard, approaching strangers, talking to people in shopping malls, get up dressed every day, going out prospecting, knowing some way, somehow, with a spirit of expectation, somebody's out here looking for an opportunity. You can go outside right now and see some pigeons, but you're out hunting for eagles, and they are not common. And if you do that over and over and over again, somebody's going to show up. Somebody's going to say, I'm the one.
The only one that can stop you from winning is you. The enemy is not your neighbor. The enemy is not your coworker. Your enemy is not your boss. That enemy is staring you in the face every morning you wake up.
If tomorrow wasn't promised, what would you give for today? Forget everything else. Forget everything else. What would you spend today? Thank you.
It's possible you can live your dream. It's necessary that you have a plan of action, that you're resilient, that you stick to, and you work with the system, that you work with people, that you give support, and that you be there for them.
The people that will make it in this life, they look around for the circumstances that they want, and if they can't find them, they create them. There's something in you that says always strive to get on top in life because it's the bottom that's overcrowded. You are different. You have greatness within you.
Don't judge your circumstances and the possibilities for your future based upon what you have now and because of what's going on now. No. That's not the real reality there. What you're going through, if you're going through some hard times, it has not come to stay, it has come to pass. It's all right.
You said to yourself, I'm going to do whatever it takes to build this business. I can do it. If anybody's ever done it at any point in time in history, then what's possible for one, it's possible for me, and I'm going to do it. That's what you said to yourself.
Got to find what you love. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking and don't settle.
As with all matters of the heart, you'll know when you find it. Stay hungry, stay foolish.
Everything's okay.
No. You always want to hold other people to the fire, but you're not holding yourself to the fire. You just said you're giving 50%. You owe you an explanation. You need to look at yourself in the mirror and say, why are you only giving 50%? What's wrong with you?
How much time do you spend every day working on your dream? In the last 90 days, how many books have you read? In the last year, what new skill or knowledge have you acquired? What kind of investment have you made in you?
People that are hungry are relentless. People that are hungry are unstoppable. People that are hungry refuse to give up. People that are hungry, no excuse is acceptable for not making their dream become a reality.
How much money do you want to make a year? What do you want to drive? How do you want to live? Stop just waking up like an accident. What do you want? And then once you find out what you want, spend the rest of your natural life waking up and going after it. If you keep being a victim, if you keep letting losing happen to you, if you keep letting people do you and treat you any kind of way, it's going to become a culture. Winners win. And losers lose. You need to tell you that you owe you something. No more TV. No more snacks. No more desserts. No, we working out now. No more alcohol. Not right now. I can't handle it right now. You need to tell you that you owe you something. I'm going to fight. I'm going to work. I'm going to press toward. I'm going to learn. I'm going to do everything in my power. Every single day, I'm going to do everything in my power to become a victor and not a victim. Winners win and losers lose.